And now a more for a Dispatches special, Age Gap Marriage, A Modern Tale of Love.
Over the next couple of weeks, we will be following a young couple from Cheltenham on the run-up to their wedding in an attempt to see what makes modern love tick.
Laura and Darren have been courting for 6 years and have finally decided to tie the knot. Darren, 41, is a pizza mogul hailing from Gloucester. And Laura, 28, is a Cheltenham It girl, working the circuit with the rich and famous.
We catch up with Darren in his office.
Obviously what I do in the office is, I check out sales of pizzas. Now, you'll be surprised to see the sales of cheesy bites at the moment. Anyways, Laura loves my job because she gets to munch away on the old slice. And she loves the slice.
Darren and Laura live in the centre of Cheltenham, in a council house. Darren shows us round.
I knew it was love when I decided to let Laura come and live with me. I used to be my bachelor, by the way. It all changed when Laura came round, though. I used to have sex on the sofa. Now I don't. I'm getting married. Have a right half again. The mother's been like, you know. Come on in, I'll show you. How did I ask Laura to marry me? Basically, I borrowed me an elephant. Yeah, got on an elephant, I pre-borrowed some Jaffa cakes from my friend Ryan. I put the rings into the Jaffa cakes, and then I went riding it into town. I knew Laura was in there. She was going down to Wilco's to buy some cleaning goods. Anyways, I walk past Laura and she goes and bloody says,
I go, get off that daft elephant, you silly pisser. You'll hurt yourself.
Get off that daft elephant, you silly pisser. And what does I shout? I shout, shut up, you bloody idiot. I'm trying to ask you to bloody marry me.
Stop it.
She's going to be Mrs. Smith now.
Laura and Darren open up to their true feelings for each other and what makes the relationship tick.
What I like about Laura is she lets me do the shopping. If she had her way, we'd just have Thinnest Crispy Pancakes all week long. But luckily, she lets me do the bloody shopping.
He's such a wonderful guy. I really do love him, yeah. I mean, he can be a little daft pisser sometimes. He's always mucking about and being naughty. But he's my wonderful Darren. And some people say, what are you doing with a chunky monkey like that? But I like a chunky monkey. A bit more to grab onto. Do you know what I mean? Oh, he's my sweetie. Do you remember
the time when you were gone? Laura and Darren invite us to one of their favourite pastimes, a walk in the park. Firm believers of spending special time together without their friends, Darren goes on to the normal topic of his iPhone.
Things are going great until Darren's condition of small man syndrome rears its ugly head and he has to do a public show of masculinity.
Doctors are unsure as to the reason behind Darren's small man syndrome, but they believe it may be his chode.
We wanted to get an outside view on the relationship, so we decided to catch up with a few of the couple's friends to see what they thought of them.
Zut alors! Now love is very much like a bicycle. It is, how you say, you fall off, you must get straight back on and try again. Also, a little chubby kid may steal it, but do not worry, you will find it in a little ditch a couple of months later with a buckled wheel. No, grand maison.
Oh yeah, we all knew Laura back in the day. Yeah, there was no one finer than that lass. Oh, if she were a goer, she would go all night long, if you know what I mean. Oh, yeah, that was until Darren made a honest woman about her. Yeah, fair play to the lad, he's a cracking one, but oh, there were some fine curves on that juicy mama. Oh, I tell thee.
Oh, how I remember meeting Laura. It was bloody amazing. It was back in the day when I was subtone owner. Obviously, everything changed when I had the adamantium put into me. But ooh, I'll tell you about that another day. Anyway, the Laura came in looking for a job, and I said, what a lovely young lady. I bet someday she'll make someone a right catch. Ooh, it's welling me up just thinking about it. That Darren, he treats her right proper.
Laura has been struggling to find the right wedding dress, and with only 4 days left, things are starting to get a little bit tense. Finally, success.
Oh, check this out. Oh, I'm gonna look delightful.
The night before the wedding, Laura and Darren decide to have a relaxing evening in with close friends Bert and Gemma and Ryan and Marie.
From the outset, Darren seems a little bit tense.
We're gonna have a fucking kisser! Let's fucking do it! Come on! Yes! Yes! Yes!
Things simmer down as board games come out, and it's Laura's turn.
Oh, it's a question! It's a question!
Okay, here we go, Laura.
Is that you nibbling on my knee?
Which animal is used to represent the World Wildlife Federation?
Oh, I know
there's
this.
There's 30 seconds.
Oh, okay. Oh, I know this.
Come on,
I know. Oh, come on. Come on.
Come on. Come on.
Oh,
come on. I have got it.
I know. Oh, I know.
What the fuck?
Oh, shut up, you daft pisser.
No.
I'm trying.
I'm trying.
I'm trying. No, fuck. No, I know.
That's it.
No, I know.
Yeah. Your hand.
That's it. Family. Fuck you all.
Things soon settle down as Darren starts talking about his iPhone. It's not a favourite subject of his friends, but they prefer him talking about his penis extension than fighting girls, which Marie is just about to find out.
Go on, eat it! Oh, eat it! Bloody, eat it! Honestly, come on!
iPhone comes out again, but all welcome the calm. But there is still one last twist in the night as the drinks start to flow.
A funny sight for most revelers, but Darren already has two suspended sentences for indecent exposure.
There's only one day to go, but Darren and Laura are still very much in love.